Oi, oi! Here we are for another shave video. How are you doing? End of the week again, or the weekend, by the time you see this video. Today is going to be another Barrister and Man, another purchase through the UK buy-sell trade. And this one is Barrister and Man Seville, which is obviously the white label. It's a barbershop scent with lanolin and shea butter. I was wondering to myself what the difference was between the white label and the black label. The black label is 6 ounce and the white label is 4 ounce. Right, so I've bloomed the puck, so I'll load that in a minute. The brush is my Smoke Owners Club 2-band Badger with cherry wood handle. The razor is the Merca 37C or the Sloan. It's in the sink of hot water. Post shave is going to be Thayer's Cucumber Witch Hazel. It's not real match to the soap, but it's Aqua Velva Musk, which is a barbershop scent. Balm is going to be the Ted Baker of London, Ted's Grooming Room Balm. It's a eucalyptus, and obviously finish off with the lovely Rock Face Moisturiser. So I just had a shower, wet the face, take my damp brush, load it up. As you may have heard me say in the last video, I sold one of my razors, the Fat Tip Testina Gentile. And the money I got for that, I bought this. Well, I've done it back to front actually. I actually bought the soap and then put my bits and pieces on, you know, me shave bits and pieces. On the UK buy sell trade. I've only sold the razor so far. Doesn't seem to be any interest in the custom brush or the other soaps I've got. So hopefully that's enough loaded there. It's a very, very nice, obviously with Barrister and Man, it's not going to be a simple scent. It's quite a complex scent, and obviously again I've been on the internet to find out scent profile. I'm quite interested in how these artisans get to these scents that they produce. Right, the Seville Shave Soap scent profile is bergamot, lemon, patchouli, oak moss, lavender, and rosemary. So I hope you've had a good week. One more work week till Christmas. Hope you've done all your Christmas shopping. Unless you're one of these people that leave it to the last minute. Never understand why people do that for. I guess they like to panic. Like the adrenaline rush. children have got a couple of more days of school before they finish for a couple of weeks. Thanks again to comments that people have left on previous videos. And if you've subscribed within the last couple of days, I believe after making my last video I forgot to thank anybody who subscribed. It's a nice thick coating there. 3 days of growth. And it's the treat blade I've got. I think that's going to be the last shave on that blade. There was one comment, sorry for not remembering your name, but they're wondering why I hold my skin up here. Obviously it's to keep this skin stretched whilst you're starting to shave. That's the way I've done it always. So. The person was wondering if I was around straight razor shaver because that's the way they obviously stretch the skin. But you just pick up tips from other people anyway. Just try and, you know, it's trial and error. But as I said, I've always done it. So because you can't hold down here obviously because there's lather, so I just hold it up there. The skin is stretched, it's taut, so. Oh, Ken Lee. Don't worry about the trolls, mate. When I first started, I got a couple of people that were making comments, negative comments. Do what you do, it's your personality coming through, so I wouldn't worry about it. I can't see the point in wasting your time, you know, leaving negative comments and thumbs down. How much the video they watch, I don't know, but they're just wasting their time. If you keep replying to their comments, they're going to come back again and just going to get out of hand. You just have to ignore them. And hopefully they'll get bored and go somewhere else. Add a little bit more water to the neck there, it's getting a bit dry. Hopefully you're aware of Paul H. Film's channel, but I don't know if you're aware of his other channel, 007 Voxel. I saw a video on there this morning, a short video of his pal Graham, and it's called Graham's Hijack My Channel or something like that. No, I watched it and I just couldn't believe it. I don't know why Paul would allow his friend to disrespect wet shavers. I don't know if it's a joke. Obviously, I didn't get it. It went over my head. But when I watched it, I couldn't believe it. Yeah, good first pass. Still got residual slickness. Look at that. I watched TSC video this morning. It seemed he's changed his video setup. believe a long time ago, that's the way he made his videos, and then he dropped out for a while and came back and then just recorded his show you piece, added an intro and an outro, which, as I said, I think that's the way he used to do his videos back in the day. And the center strength of this is probably between 7 and 8. Let's say 7.5. Across the grain. Someone asked a question on one of the Facebook groups the other day. Do you prefer synthetic brushes or badger brushes? I prefer the badger brushes over synthetic. Synthetic are good, but when you think traditional wet shave, and I think badger brushes, so plus badger brushes hold the moisture where these synthetic ones don't. I'm not against synthetic brushes, obviously, because I've got a couple myself, but my go-to brush is definitely a badger. And the competition I spoke about in the last video that Kirby Shaves won. Erica Salmon, the soap artisan, she made a video on how she makes her soaps, which was very interesting. And she was actually putting together the soap that's going to be for sale. I think it's in the new year, which is Kevvy's soap. So I'm looking forward to hearing his review when he gets it. That's pass two. Still loads of soap on the brush. Again, with brushes, synthetics, you can just pick it up and use it. Obviously, you've got to add moisture, or a little bit of water at a time to build up your lather. Natural hair brushes like Badger and Boar and Horse need to be broken in a little bit before they perform to their maximum. I'm just dipping the tips of the brush and my mug down here that's got some bloom water in it. Keep adding a little bit more water, especially in the third pass against the grain. This is a little more slicker. Weather's been quite mild here the last few days. I also watched Nick Shave's video the other day when he shaved his moustache off. He shaved his beard off after No Shave November, or Movember, left his moustache. And he won a competition at work, the best looking moustache or something, so well done, Nick. What type of brushes do you like? No, what's your go-to brush if you want to shave? Is it a boar, badger, synthetic? And Chris's channel, another cut above. He's got to his 250 subscribers. So he's doing a giveaway. If you haven't subscribed to his channel, go ahead there and get in on the giveaway. I'm just going to take a little bit. I'm not going to take all of it out. You don't need all of it. I found if the lather's too thick, you can't feel what's underneath, because obviously the glide, your hand is just going to glide over. So I just put a bit on like that and then dip my fingers in the water, so it thin it out a little bit, and then you can feel where you need to touch up. Big D, Dale, hopefully you've got your razor now. What's your favourite shaving soap or cream scent? Is it the cologne type scents or barbershop? Citrus? That'll do. That's good enough. Yep. Just do the Kevvy shaves and rub a bit in. So let's put some thayers on now and then we'll go through the styles of the shave. Right, we start the soap. Paris Tourmaine Seville. Barbershop Scent, Smoke Owners Club, that's the two-band badger with the cherry wood handle. Razor was the Merca Slant, or 37C. Oops, wrong way. Thayer's Cucumber, Witch Hazel. I've got the Aqua Velva Musk, which Kevvy brought back from the States for me. Thanks again, Kevvy. It's got quite a large hole there, so I just put my index finger over to reduce the flow. Nice powdery scent. Oops. I'll put on the balm, which I said was eucalyptus. Quite a pasty, thick balm. And then just to finish off the rock face. Definitely worth getting this rock face if you can find it. Absorbs nicely into the skin. Doesn't make your skin look greasy. There we are, fantastic shave. Right, that's the end of another shave. Thanks for watching, thanks for liking. Any comments, questions, leave them in the comments box below. Have a great weekend, have some great shaves, and I'll see you again next week for another shave. Cheers, bye.